is guided meditation. First of all, close the eyes. With the eyes closed, just to check the posture. How are your legs? Really get to experience them as fully as possible. With your eyes closed, feel them down from the in your butt, then your lower half of your body. If you have gone too fast, you can always go back again to relax. You experience, you feel, you know. And there is no one posture that is the perfect one for you. Every place, every time, it will change. You adapt accordingly. Your mindfulness gives you information, gives you data. And you can change positions. Move this way, that way. Stretch, relax, slump. Till you find the best for you now. Your neck, your head balanced on top. Sometimes when you are meditating and you let go, become peaceful, really aware, sometimes the body adjusts itself. Sometimes it's the back straightens up or slumps. Sometimes it moves to the side. Sometimes the head goes forward or back. Much of your body is autonomous. A lot of the time, it knows better than you how to sit, how to walk, how to go. It even knows how to cough. So just let it cough its way, not your way. And the whole purpose of this scan of the body in the beginning is to relax to the max. You do see animals relaxing, dogs and cats. They don't think too much. They feel. In your head. Much of the tension in life is written on your face. So I become really aware of the muscles on my face. One by one, I loosen them. Relaxing them, taking off any stretching, any compression, any tension. And if it works for you, a couple of inches behind your eyes, your brain. When we think and argue and complain, or we plan because of fear, we remember our past is so heavy. That's like it's tiring out our brain, exhausting it. So we imagine, visualize our brain. We relax. Once our body is relaxed, you can linger longer on your body if it needs more attention. As I said in an earlier talk, whenever I would get injured, I would remember growing up in Acton, playing on the streets, the football around the school playground on asphalt, so often just falling to the ground, scraping the skin off my knees. I always remember just having scabs on my knees as I grew up. But every time was a fresh road, running, crying to my mother, who would stoop down and kiss it better. Just the amazing power of kindness to take away pain, to heal, to relieve. So now I do that with my own mind. As any pain aches, it's as if, metaphorically, I kiss it better. Being kind to my body. I'm kind to my brain. Really kind to the whole body. So kind. I realize I do not have to prove anything. I'm at peace with myself in this moment. Later on I can work, argue. Right now, I'm alone, at peace. The Buddha said, being an island unto myself. In my island, there's no criticism. Being here, breathing. Minimum amount of work. I just feel the breath. In fact, it's not even located anywhere on my body. Just breathing, that's all. With my little island, my bubble. If there's any sound outside, any disturbance, I keep it at a distance. It's not my business. It's way over there, and I'm inside, going deeper and deeper into this. I'm not at all concerned with anything outside. And then I move away from whatever I'm watching and pay attention to my face. And I smile. If you can't make one, fake one. Turning up the corners of your mouth into a smile. And then I go back inside. A tiny bit of happiness and calmness can sometimes bring appreciation for the opportunity to be peaceful. Some people are negative, they criticize anything. With a smile, an appreciation and gratitude for this, the opportunity to be still. The opportunity to accept this moment as it is, to be at peace with it. Now, this moment, me, whatever you take yourself to be, I open the door of my heart to this. There's no right, no wrong in this moment. That judgment comes from what we call proliferation later. Just being. No plans. No opening up the filing cabinets of the past, looking for something to solve. I'm just here in this moment. So might you travel a long way to be here. The mind and the body will be tired. Now you have a bench, a seat, calm now. This moment. It might not be the most comfortable seat in the world. Is good enough to be sit down, being here. Be grateful to have a place to sit. being here. Value the ability to be quiet with no one asking anything of you. Surround yourself with kindness. Non-judgmental, non-measuring love. As you are, is good enough. Now we take you to another level. Imagine, visualize, feel as if you're sitting under a huge, cool tree. Imagine you're the Buddha. It's like acting the part, feeling it from inside. Sitting here. Complete, finished, nothing missing. What had to be done has been done. There's no more work for you to do. No more striving. No more endeavor. Your home. You're just sitting here, enjoying the breeze, for no reason whatsoever. No longer are you doing something for a purpose. You're just being. Experiencing your breath come and go. Experiencing the sounds, soft, as soon as they disappear, they're gone forever. Holding on to nothing, not keeping anything from the past. Living these moments without taking notes. Knowing that in this moment the future is involved. It grows out of this moment like a flower bursts from the bud. This moment is healthy and pure. The future has to be beautiful. So just here, still, why do things move? Why are we so afraid of letting go? Feel the peace. It's another type of happiness and joy. The happiness of contentment. Not seeing any faults with what you're experiencing. Not seeing the two bad bricks in a wall. being at peace with this. Content and easily satisfied. Not proud and having to stand out above others. But easily satisfied. One who disappears. Fades away. Imagine this thing you call you expanding, getting thinner, dissipated, lighter, evaporating. With all your history, good and bad, things you're proud of, things you'd rather hide. All of it evaporating, like water turning to steam, like steam turning to mist, going to all parts of the universe, to the indiscernible, yeah, there is nothing there, emptiness. And this moment is delightful, restful, and you're happy to be here. What more do you want? This is it, this is the end. Being here, content. Your real home. When you stay in this moment, time has no meaning. Time is a future or a past to exist. Now, there is no time. As if you rest your brain, your thoughts, in this very soft chair, calm now. The cushions of the present, they just soak in, absorb all of the wanting, all of the wanting, the effort, was all just to be here. Now you're here, nothing else to do. Please keep that smile on the face. It helps you stay here. And just allow the attention to notice the happiness, the delight, the freedom. Freedom of not having to perform, not having to do things. Freedom of not having to follow orders. Freedom of not having to please others. Totally let go. Disengage. Just be inside. deeply with this. Feel the peace, the lack of movement, contentment, not the boredom of having nothing to do, the joy of stillness. The joy of stillness becomes so attractive. Let the joy stick you like glue to this moment. Just be here. No judging, no measuring, no assessing. To guide your home. Amen. great. Father, pray. Put it in one end, take it out the other. Another 10 minutes we can have a sutta class. Go to the Buddha.